Hello and welcome to Skyvia Tutorials. In today's video, we'll check how to integrate Salesforce and Zendesk with no coding. We have selected the scenario of loading Zendesk tickets to Salesforce cases for this tutorial. We will also briefly touch other popular integration cases. Skyvia offers different tools for automating Salesforce and Zendesk integration. For example, data flow and import ETL tools can be used to load both legacy and new tickets. The automation product allows trigger action automation of workflows. It can automate creating Salesforce cases from new Zendesk tickets too. This tutorial assumes you already have a Skyvia account. If you don't have it, you can create it for free by following the link in the description. Before you start building integrations, you need to create connections to the corresponding data sources. Skyvia supports most popular CRMs, including Salesforce, Dynamics 365, Zoho CRM, HubSpot, and others. It supports other cloud apps, databases like MySQL, data warehouses, etc. To create a connection to Salesforce, in the Create New menu, select Connection, then look for Salesforce in the list. Sign in with your credentials, name your connection, and save it. You can create an OAuth Zendesk connection in the same way. Click Create New, select Connection, select the Zendesk connector. Then select the OAuth 2.0 authentication, specify your Zendesk subdomain, and sign in with Zendesk. Once connections are created, we can proceed to Salesforce and Zendesk integration. Let's start with the Data Flow tool and show the automation later. The Data Flow tool is a better choice when you need to load a lot of data, including both legacy and new records. It is a designer-based tool, which you set up by adding components to the diagram and directing flows of data between them. To create a data flow, click Create New and select Data Flow. First, add the source component that will query tickets data from Zendesk. Let's select our Zendesk connection and execute query action. Execute command action queries data within SQL command, and execute query lets you configure the query visually. In the execute query action, select ticket fields to query. We can navigate relations and select fields from the related objects too. A ticket in Zendesk references the requester, user, and organization. We assume that Zendesk users are already synchronized with Salesforce contacts and organizations with accounts. Now we want to link the result case in Salesforce to the corresponding contact and account. Let's use lookup components to find the IDs of the corresponding Salesforce account and contact. In the lookup component, select the Salesforce connection and lookup action. The first or default behavior means that lookup selects the first matching record, and if no matching records found, a null value is passed for the queried field. The first lookup component will obtain the ID of the corresponding Salesforce account by its name. Let's map the lookup parameter to the name field from the input Zendesk fields. To avoid ID of the account being overridden by ID of the contact later, specify property for the lookup. Now, let's add a similar lookup component that queries the ID of a contact by email. Finally, add the target component to load data into Salesforce. Select the Salesforce connection and the insert action. We insert data to the case object. For insert action, we must map the case fields to which we want to load data. We can use automapping to automatically map input columns with the same names, so only the relation fields are left to map manually. Now this data flow can load all Zendesk tickets, including legacy ones, to Salesforce cases. how to modify it so that the integration could be run periodically and loaded only new records. First, we need to add a parameter to store the last ticket creation date between data flow run. The initial value that we set here determines the period for which the first data flow run will load legacy tickets. Then let's modify the execute query action in the source. We'll add the ticket creation date to the query and query only records created after the date time in the parameter. Then we need to update the parameter value. For this, let's add the value component after the source. We'll get max ticket creation date and assign it to our parameter. Now our data flow will load only new records each time. The data flow is fully functional now, but it does not provide any logging yet. With Data Flow tool, you can configure error logging as you need to make debugging easier and have detailed information in case of any errors. We can create variables to count successfully inserted and failed records and fill them with row count components. After this, we need to set up expressions for the numbers of successful and failed records that we will see in the integration log. For our simple data flow, we will just select the corresponding variables. Data flow allows creating per record error logs. Let's create a log table for failed records. It will store error messages and ticket subjects. We can add columns for any other fields to the log as well. Data flow writes data to a log with the target component. Select the log connection and our created log table. Then map the columns of the log table. That's all, our data flow is ready. Let's name and save it. We can schedule it for automatic execution. You can run it every day or on specific weekdays, more often than once per day, every few hours or even minutes. At any time, you can run data flow manually and see the result details and logs that you have configured on the monitor tab. Now we can show how to implement this scenario with the automation product. Automation can load only new data, but it allows setting up workflows with more complex logic and performing a wider variety of actions. To create an automation, click Create New and select Automation. In this video, we won't show the creation process itself. We will show an existing automation and show all its settings. Every automation starts with a trigger. We use the connection trigger for the Zendesk connection. It fires for new records added to the tickets table. The automation checks for the new events every poll interval. We select the following fields from the new ticket. Then we use the action component to query the requester email by the requester ID field from the trigger. After this, we obtain the ID of the corresponding contact in Salesforce by email. We assume that users in Zendesk are synced with contacts in Salesforce, so we don't consider cases when the contact is not found. Zendesk tickets may reference an organization. We use the if component to check whether the process ticket has a reference to the organization. If organization ID is not null, we find the corresponding organization name first. And then we find the ID of the corresponding account in Salesforce by the obtained name. Finally, we insert the data into Salesforce cases. If organization ID is null in the ticket, we simply insert data to Salesforce cases without the corresponding account ID. After we configure this automation, we enable it, and new tickets in Zendesk automatically appear in Salesforce as cases. Let's see how our automation works. Let's create a new ticket in Zendesk. Automation runs can be found on the Monitor tab. Click Debug to see the run detail, which actions fired with which data. For most common integration cases, Skyvia offers a gallery of predefined integrations where you only need to select connections. There are several integrations for connecting Zendesk and Salesforce. Let's look at the integration that syncs Zendesk users to Salesforce contacts. It is an import integration. Skyvia Import is an ETL tool that is easier to use but less sophisticated than Dataflow. Let's see how import integrations are configured. In the import integration, you need to select source and target connections and add import tasks. For example, our predefined integration selects new Zendesk users with their organization data. You can toggle off the inserted state filter to load all the users. The integration uses the upcirc operation to load data to Salesforce contact. The upcirc operation updates a target record if it exists and creates a record in the target if it doesn't exist. Thus, no duplicates of existing records are created. Finally, you can configure mapping for the import task. Skyvia offers different kinds of mapping: column to column, constants, lookups, expressions with various operators, mathematical, string, date time functions, and others. Thank you for watching this Zendesk and Salesforce integration tutorial. If you have any additional questions, feel free to drop us a comment below and we will help you. To try Skyvia for free, use the link in the description. See you in the next videos.